Hi all you coffee lovers, welcome back. We're back at Rangura with Coffee Worx, and today I'm going to talk to all those aspiring home baristas about how to do a really good extraction on your coffee. There's quite a few elements that you need to know about extraction, and it doesn't matter what type of coffee machine you've got at home. Thinking about the elements that make extraction is going to help you make great espresso. So last time we talked a lot about the grind. The grinder is an essential part of this process because it's helping us to set the pressure. Thinking about the grind, if I had a bucket of gravel and poured water through it compared to a bucket of sand, the water would pour much more freely through the gravel and it could get waterlogged in the sand. And that's a little bit what our grind is all about. On your grinder, you'll see that it has something that says either coarse or fine, or maybe you're getting your coffee ground for you. But it's very important that it is the right size so that as the water comes down and hits your pack, that it actually can run through the grinds in a controlled manner. The first thing we do is on these types of machines, I'm going to always use a guide for my fill. And I'll be filling my basket to this guideline here, which I'm going to consider to be my pressure line. I'm going to set my grinder, I'm going to fill my basket, and then I'm going to temp it to add an additional amount of pressure. When I'm doing my grind, I want to make sure that I've got no air in the basket. I often stop halfway through and just knock all the air out. I do it again at the end. I want to make sure that this has got no air pockets in it, because as the pressure comes through, if it hits the air pockets, it's going to break the pressure seal that I'm trying to make through this extraction. Then I take my temper and I give it a nice firm temp. On the machine, we have what's called the head. So as the water comes from the boiler to the head, there's actually a little mesh screen here, and I want to create a pressure pack right here where I want the water to run ideally through every grind that I have created in here. If I can do that in a controlled manner, I can grab all the little bits of oil that are attached to each grind as it runs through the extraction. What I do is always rinse out my head before I put my handle in. The reason I'm doing that is that all of these styles of machines actually have a heat exchanger coming from the boiler to the head, and we need to lower the temperature of the water from 100 degrees, which is what it would be in the boiler, to around 96 degrees, which it would be in the head. So once I've done that, I pop in my handle. I want it to be in there nice and secure. I don't want any pressure to escape. And then I'm going to make my extraction. There should be a little buildup of pressure, and then the extraction should start to run. And often people talk about mouse tails. Remember, mouse tails are quite small, so it should be nice and fine. And I'm looking at the way it's running. Once it starts going white and light, we call it blonding, I know that all the oil that was in that extraction has come out. And we get this lovely, rich looking oil coming through, which we call crema. Crema actually means cream. This is the cream of the coffee, and that's what we're looking for in our extraction process. Is it a lovely, rich caramel colour? Is it glossy and shiny and syrupy? I don't want to see lots of major colour variations in my extraction. I don't want to see really dark to really light, because what I'm looking for is even and balance in the flavours. The more even my extraction pours, the more it pours in a lovely, rich caramel from the beginning to the end, the more I'm going to have those rich flavours coming through in its flavour profile. So I'm always wanting to see smooth, rich. I just know then that I'm going to be making myself a delicious espresso. So with your extraction, remember, the grind is going to be a very important part of it. So just play around with your grind a little bit until you see that extraction starting to pour beautifully. And remember that once you see it going blonde or white at the end, all the crema has been brought out of the coffee, so you need to stop it there just to make sure no bitter flavours are coming through. And the most important thing is, coffee is all about experimentation. Just try different things until you feel you have got the perfect extraction.